Okay, here we go, part one of New Vegas. And lag, apparently. Right. Anyway, I've skipped past the tutorial because I'm sick to death of doing it, so I'm in the next town now. I'll carry on from here. So you haven't missed anything really, just some training and free guns. Now I have to go into that building over there and rescue the deputy of this town. Are you kidding? These asshats. Really? Oh. Yay, they see me. Oh my god, what's happened to my aim? Bats. Quick. Why is it working? Well, fudge. Shotgun. In here, girls. Quickly. Frag mine. And one here. Here I am. Get me. Come on, princess. Up the stairs.
You like that?
Oh, you. Oh dear. Ooh, a landmine survived. Score. You, my idiotic friend, did not survive. And here I am taking your shit. Take the outfit too. What the hell? Oh. Where did the other guy go? Pretty sure there's two of them. Oh. No, it's not you. Oh, the other guy had the outfit I wanted. Maybe if I... No? Nothing? Oh, come on. Oh. What? Where'd the other guy go? To shoot him. Hello, bandits, guy thing, where are you? Nice. Yes, please. Yes. No, I don't want a knife. Maybe he came in here with his friend and died? I just didn't see where he landed.
Found you. Mojave, mold problems. Am I right? Got some Dean Martin coming up. Talking about the pre-
There we go. EDE, my friend, I will fix you as soon as I have the parts, I promise. The junk. See if the shopkeeper dude's got some goodies to sell.
I don't know what it was brought you to Prim, youngster, but you might want to rethink your plans. Town's gone to hell. Johnson Nash is my name. Husband to Ruby Nash. Lived in Prim going on 8 years now, thick and thin. I'm a trader primarily, for what it's worth, with things like they are. I also run the local Mojave Express outpost.
Okie dokie. Do you have anything to sell?
Sure, have a look.
Spank you very much. Oh, wait, exit. Exit. Bye-bye. Let's fix them all up first, so we'll get more money for them.
Hey, youngster. Still hanging about Prim, huh?
Damn straight. Sell me stuff. You can has that, and you can has that, and that. Have, like, 17 of these. You mean 12. Nice. Ugh, no. A shovel? Why? Right, what guns have you got with you? Nothing I want. Needs miscellaneous. Oh, really? Tempting. Right. Speaking of ammo, I'm gonna sell one I don't need. Don't need those. Keep them, keep them, keep them. Half of those. I'll take all of those. And them. And all them. No, no. Magnum rounds too, just in case I happen across my favorite gun. Cheers, dude.
Thanks.
Ta-ta.
Later.
Yep. Alright, weapons. Machete, slot one. In my lazy pistol. In my pea shooter. Shotgun. Raid rifle, dynamites. Okay. Everything's hunky dory. Okay, fine. Here we go. head straight away. There's always a guy in here. Oh god, there's two. Oh god. Ready, ready. Stop shooting me, it's dangerous. Eight. No, damn it, wrong button.
Look out!
Where did that land? Thanks for the gun, dude. Money. I don't really want it. Yeah, just take it all, stuff it. Yep. Mine. And that. You got. Let's see, friend. Got any nasty surprises while I'm looking around? Easy. Obviously not. Computer terminal thing. Eight magazines. It's on the top. Unarmed. Survival. Guns. Science. Ah, yes, science! Right. Wrong. Try again. Seaside. Station. Reaches. Nope. Try again. Before the magazine runs out. Come on. Oh. Bollocks. Come on. Don't think I've ever been in this room, so let me check, see if there's anything cool. Pretty please. Nope. Dang it. Try again. Radio. Sermons? No. Animals. Hooray! Fifth time's a charm. Unlocked door. Bryce and Steve maintenance key. Go in handy. Ooh, lunchbox, mine. Bubblegum. Nice. Bottle caps. Pistol. Med X. Brad X. Not bad. Atomic cocktail. Yes, please. Mentats. Damn it, I always mispronounce that. Dirty water, empty syringe, rebound, steady. Oh. That's so unfair. Well, at least I know there's a safe worth exploring this man in the area. Hollow points, armor piercing, here we go. Another safe. Oh god. Won't be unlocking that safe anytime soon. No box. Nothing. Looks like I'll be making a trip back here when I'm at a higher level. Unlock those safes.
Found you.
Way.
You like that? I'm hit.
Tell.
Oh crap!
I can't shit with this thing. Oh wait, six. Fire! My gun's bigger than your gun. Your gun looks pretty cool. Right, rob him. Repair. Sorry, microphone. Incinerator. Yes. Well, I can't read too much about it, can I? Unless I have some weapon repair kits, which I don't. Anyway.
And we're back. This is Mr. New Vegas, and I feel something magic in the air tonight. And I'm not just talking about the gamma radiation. Here are our top stories. Scavengers report hulking individuals moving around in Valley after dusk, but have been unable to identify them due to low visibility. Also in the headlines, Caesar's Legion continues to fortify its position where it remains a constant concern for Camp Forlorn Hope and the nearby town of Novak. Mojave? Mo problems. Am I right? And now, I'd like to play one of my very favorite songs for you.
You do that. Ooh, right song. Hardly spoke to folks around him, didn't have to the glasses off. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared to make a slip. The stranger there among them had a big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was early in the morning when he rode into the town. He came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw loose and precious goodies. From each lip, and he's here to do some business with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. In this town there lived an outlaw by the name of Texas Red. Many men tried to take him and that many men
marvelous.
Okay, imbecile.
I don't suppose you came here to rescue me.
Unfortunately,
I'd cross my fingers, but my hands are numb. Why, I'm Deputy Beagle, and I'm being held hostage. Can you imagine? I'd be most grateful if you would set me free.
My jaw is agape with shock. Retard.
Oh, that's just marvelous. Then I'll defer to your superior.
Just go away. Wasn't long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry men that tried before day. Why are you crouching? There's no one left. Seriously? Oh, weirdo. One would be the ranger with
the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Howdy.
Well, that was quite an adventure. Breaking myself out of a hostage situation. Not to diminish your role in it, of course. But it was quite thrilling.
You asshole!
Problem is, there's still no law in Prim. What are we to do the next time ruffians menace us and hold us hostage?
Yeah, what are you talking about? You're the sheriff now, imbecile.
Oh, no. I'm just the deputy, and I can't be a deputy without a sheriff. It's called chain of command.
Well, your sheriff is dead, so that makes you the sheriff.
It should be someone brave like you, but more of a homebody. Someone who'll settle down and watch over us. I heard the Powder Gangers talking about someone in the prison named Myers who has some experience as a sheriff. He may be a good choice. Also, with the NCR so close by, you may be able to get them to take over the town. Not sure why they haven't helped out already.
Fine. I'll do your work for you.
You will? That's just marvelous. I'll start thinking up questions for the interview. The sheriff that was incarcerated up at NCRCF may be a good choice. You also may be able to convince that NCR guy across the road to take the town under his wing. Although martial law doesn't sound so fun.
So I'm raiding a prison then. Bloody hell. So be it. First things first, let's check these two shacks for some goodies. Sheriff's office. Horace. Terrible. How was that? Good enough. Make myself some Magna Brands. For a gun I don't own. Ugh, stupid boy. Oh, score! Office has ammo but no guns. Really? Nothing? Sheriff's duster. Sheriff's hat. Cool. Well, might as well rob him. Cowardly jerk that he is. I'll take that. Silenced pistol, eh? Grilled mantis. Yeah. Pre-food. Pretty pear fruits. Take all of those. Right. Let's get out of here. Head to that prison and free this bloody sheriff. Or not. Just go sell some of this junk as I'm weighed down. Then go free the sheriff.
Hey, youngster. Still.
Yep. Don't want. Ah, I'll keep that. Binoculars. Keep. Ah, sell machete. And three of these. Gecko steaks. Grilled mantis. I'll eat that in a minute. Sell that horrible cockroach meat. Yes. Oh, no. Miscellaneous. What have we got? Sell those two. Ammo I don't need. That. Here we go.
Pleasure doing business with you.
Yeah, you got a bargain. Charge so like 700 quid worth of stuff for 200. Yeah. Sorry, hello. Ooh, actually. Wait. Do you still have that wood for the baseball bat?
Hey, youngster. Sure, have a...
Miscellaneous. Baseball bat, there it is. I'll take that.
Thanks.
Toodaloo. Right, prison. Quests. World map. Where's this prison? Oh. Fast travel nearby. Okay, right. Prison. Map. Wrong way. That way? Yes. Don't lie. I see you. Go away.
Hello there. It's good to see a friendly face. I almost took you for a raider, I did. Name's Malcolm. Malcolm Holmes.
Hey,
don't suppose you'd care to trade. I'm missing a few essentials and... screw this. Lying just ain't in my nature. I'll tell it to you straight. I've been following you for a good bit now. It started off innocently enough. I was traveling, as I often do, and happened to observe you picking up one of those blue star caps. You didn't show any reaction to it, so I figured you didn't know what you'd gotten your hands on. I had to make sure of your disposition. There's a lot of jumpy folks out there that'll shoot a man as soon as talk to him. Now that we're conversing, though, I can tell you what I know about those caps. There's an old wasteland legend that says somewhere out there is a fabulous treasure from before the war. Those caps with the blue star on them, the tale goes, are the key to that treasure. They're called Sunset Sarsaparilla Stars. Nah, I gave it up years ago. Too dangerous. And even if I did still collect them, I'd tell you the same. There's people out there so mad with the idea of treasure that they'll attack strangers just on the suspicion that they have some of those caps. All over the place. The easiest place to find them is unopened bottles of Sunset Sarsaparilla. You'd think they'd all have been picked clean by now, but somehow, new bottles keep appearing in the machines. Some say it's old Festus that does it, hoping someone will finally collect enough caps to earn the treasure. Other than bottles, you'll just have to scavenge. You can find caps in the unlikeliest of places, and blue star caps are no exception. It's said that the treasure is guarded by a man named Festus, and he's the one who asked for the blue star caps. It's also said he's been around since the war, standing a lonely vigil, waiting for someone to come and take the treasure off his hands. That'll make him pretty damn old, but I've met a few people in my travels who claim they actually met him, and they weren't the lying type either.
Okay.
No problem. If you do end up trying to collect more stars, watch out for a man named Alan Marks. He's killed several people for their stars already.
Wait a minute.
Huh? You want to talk some more?
Oh, you do trade.
Oh, that's right. Here, let me show you what I've got on hand.
I'll take that. No. In fact, you keep it at that price. We'll take those, though. Accept. Ta-ta. Right, onto the prison. You get the special done for that. No one messes with Telazer. Mwahaha. Take the ammo and the pistol, thank you. Oh, you butthead, what have you got on you? Thank you. Nothing I want. Well. Hey, Brock Lava. Nice. Some more. Don't mind if I do. This orange you get on my nerves. Settings, display, white. Hey, that's better. Can you see me? No? Good. Oh dear, found the prison. Wrong button. I couldn't hit the side of a barn from inside the barn. Good lord. Much better. God. I did hit him then. Six. Aim up and fire. Too low. Try again. Good lord, my aim is terrible. Oh my god! Didn't realize I was that bad. You need to be quite good at sniping. What? Ooh. Oh dear. Holy crap, where did you come from? Shot. Very proud. Right. Right. Actually, I'll take that too. Oh, I can see you. So I am hitting you then. Please, thank you. Outdoors. I see you have a magnum. What kind of condition is it in? Good enough to be used.
Maybe. Fly farther and faster for you. In combat, you do 75% critical damage against animals and muted animals. Lady killer. Oh, it's the opposite of confirmed bachelor. Rapid reload. Rapid reload makes all of your weapon reloads 25% faster. You lose karma, and if the act is witnessed, it is considered a crime against nature. So, why would I want it? Nah. Well, that went. Educated. Corpses. Who the hell are you? Didn't know anyone would willingly walk into this place. Not unless they were looking for trouble. What's your story? I was a sheriff, believe it or not.
Oh, found you.
A small town far to the west of here. Short version is that sometimes justice is a little slow. I helped speed it up one too many times. I'm not sorry for anything I did, but I will do the time. Fair enough trade if you ask me. Assuming an NCR pardon comes with the job, and it had better. I also need to be able to do things my own way. Due process has its place. Sometimes it's just a waste of time. I'll need to know that I'm not going to end up right back in prison.
Okay.
All right, then. Guess I'll just make a quiet exit. No need for a goodbye party or anything.
So, can I leave now, or should I go further into the prison? No. Do some other time. Anyway, I think that's enough for the day, so here we go.